Guidance release. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9.
Sequences started.
Have ignition sequence start.
5.
The engine's now building up to 7.7 million pounds of thrust.
All engines running. Launch commit and liftoff.
We have a launch commit and we have a liftoff. The swing arm is moving back.
Some plugs go to the moon.
We cleared the tower.
Roger, clear the tower.
Houston is now controlling.
Oh, you have good thrust in all five.
Roger.
Pitch and roll program started.
Other plugs? Well, I climb Mount Everest.
But my dream has always been to go drive a Formula One car. But I can't do it from here. Apart from a few days a year in March when the Formula One circus rolls into Melbourne, there are no Formula One cars in Australia. So I had to save all my money and travel to the other side of the world, to a place called Provence in the south of France.
In the past 6 months, I've driven everything I could get my hands on that would go fast, from go-karts to Formula Ford, even with a trip over to New Zealand to drive what's called a Formula Challenge car. But nothing could really prepare me for what I was about to face.
So here now is my little documentary. Driving a Formula One car? No worries.
Shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted. One moment to capture, just let it slip. Yo, his palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface, he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking now, everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over loud. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes gravity, choke. He's so mad, but he won't give up. Daddies, he know, he won't have it, he knows. So back to these ropes, it don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's broke. He's so sad that he knows when he goes back to this mobile home. That's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old man said he better go back to this moment and hope it don't give it. Lose his mouth in the music, the moment you own it. You better never let go. Only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose his mouth in the music, the moment you own it.
Morning, Jack.
Hello. Morning.
How are we?
I'm Ryan. Good. Good, thank you.
Good. storm clouds are forming on the day of your big drive, mate. Feelings?
Yes, a couple of storm clouds. Haven't had much sleep. The mozzies were getting us all last night. And it was hot last night in bed, so didn't get a lot of sleep, so feeling a bit patchy today, but she'll be right.
On the way to the track, I was given plenty of encouragement by my two very good mates.
Shit yourself, yeah?
All under control, mate, at this time.
we've got all the bags over here. And what else do we need today? Helmet.
Low and
Germany's finest.
Rather warm Weiss beer. And what's in here, mate? What's in that red thing?
Jack's big helmet.
Did you spend all night polishing your helmet? We're at the gates, mate. It's the ticker starting to.
We're at the gates, mate.
The ticker's still okay. Mate. There we are.
We're waiting for. I don't know. One of Bernie's boys to come down and open the gates at the moment. Yeah. A bit early. This will be interesting. Everyone's got to pull out the French at this stage. Okay. Hey, bonjour. No.
Bonjour.
The Paul Ricard Circuit has a long history of motor racing, including having previously hosted the French round of the Formula One World Championship. In the year 2000, it was brought by billionaire businessman and F1 supremo, Bernie Eccleston, who spent millions upgrading the circuit. Oh, and if the entrance to the place wasn't daunting enough, I then had to be confronted by a picture of an icon of the sport as I walked into the change rooms. Thank you for that. I soon discovered that my dream drive would have to wait at least a little while longer. I was kitted out by a very fancy three-layer fireproof suit from the AGS Formula One team, and it was then time to go for a spin to test my skills in what's called an F3 car. This is basically a lower formula car. This thing is still capable of doing around 200 kilometres an hour, and it only weighs about 495 kilograms. The car has a 6-speed sequential gearbox, which I can control simply by shifting paddles up and down, which are located directly behind my steering wheel. Being so light and with a very good power to weight ratio, this car will go from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in around about 3 seconds and continue up to do a top speed of just under 200 kilometers an hour. Taking one of these things for a spin is going to be a fantastic way for me to learn the circuit. So, here we go for a ride in an F3 car.
Sleeping in a world beyond control.
With the F3 drive successfully out of the way, it was time for the real deal. And here it is.
The Prost AP02. Initially driven in the Formula One World Championships by John Alesi and Nick Heidfeld, it's a pretty daunting machine.
Forget anything you know about a normal road car.
The brakes are made of carbon fibre and can reach temperatures of up to 1,000 degrees. The car only weighs about a third of the average family car.
And yet, at 650 brake horsepower, has around 6 times the power.
And the name Prost? Well, that's the car's original team owner. That's 4 times Formula One world champion, Alain Prost. It takes a whole team to prepare this car for a few laps around it.